Sports Network presents San Diego State Aztec Football. Brought to you by Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you. And by Ball, Olds, and Honda, located on National City's Mile of Cars. And by the Aspen Mine Company for fine food and spirits.
San Diego, Jack Murphy Stadium, San Diego, California. Tonight, the San Diego State Aztecs take on the University of Texas El Paso Miners. Well, hi, everybody. I'm Ron Reno, along with Bob Babich. This is, in fact, San Diego Stadium, Aztecs' final home game of the year. They're 5-4, and they're meeting the Texas El Paso Miners, who are 1-8. Bob Babich, your thoughts about tonight's football game?
Well, I think it should be an easy one for San Diego State. I don't see UTEP possessing any problems for them.
All right, the Aztecs coming off a win over Nevada, Las Vegas last week, 38-20. You feel like it gives them a little momentum coming into this one?
I think they do. They had their offense on track. They had a good balance. They had good running with Donnie Roberts. Matt started throwing the ball again like he did early in the season. So I think they'll keep this momentum going through this ballgame.
All right, obviously Texas El Paso is struggling, so is it possible they may do some tricks and blitzing and different things?
Well, they can. They had a bye last week. They've had 2 weeks to prepare for this ballgame, so we could see almost anything with them.
And you expect what kind of an outcome?
State by a wide margin.
There it is, the prediction from Bob Babich, a wide margin thrust to your bookie. All right, Aztecs, final home game tonight for a lot of seniors, and they're meeting Texas El Paso Miners. We'll find out what happens shortly. We'll be back with the Doug Scoble Show right after this.
The 1980 Winter Olympics. Hockey team captain Michael Ruzioni helped clinch the gold for the U.S.
I'm Michael Ruzioni, the artist. Budweiser asked me to paint with these to help raise funds for America's Olympic athletes. Now you can own my painting and help our athletes train for 84. After all, there are a lot of Picassos. There's only one, Ruzioni.
Call 1-800-325-1488 for more information.
Here's Gene Burdett, athletic director at San Diego State, with a special message. Gene?
Thanks, Ron. Over the past 12 years, Dave Ball and Ball Old Honda have been great supporters of the Aztec Athletic Foundation. And this year they've come up with what I think is a great idea. Every time the Aztecs score a touchdown during the season, Ball Old Honda will contribute $100 to the Aztec Athletic Foundation.
Well, we'd like to thank Ball Olds and wish them a great year. And we all hope the Aztecs score a lot of touchdowns and really get into Dave's pocket.
The Doug Scoble Show is brought to you by Coca-Cola, Nuttall Styrus, and by Newcorp Corporation. And now, here is Coach Doug Scoble and Ron Reno.
And at the Hilton Hotel on Mission Bay with head coach Doug Scoble, I'm Ron Reno. And the Aztecs get ready to play Texas El Paso. Now, Doug, coming off the Nevada victory, now meeting Texas El Paso, concerned for you and your players this week of being able to get up. It's a little hard to get up for Texas El Paso with your mind on a ball game.
I think it is to a certain degree. There's no question about it. We didn't have a very good practice Tuesday, but we came back Wednesday and Thursday and practiced well. Because the guys made a commitment back there at Vegas that they were going to start a new season and try to win the last three, and this was number two on it. So I think they kind of got their attention going a little better later in the week.
All right. Now, also, is there a concern on your part the fact that UTEP had a week off prior? They had a bye. Also, it seems that going nowhere, that they may throw all kinds of wild different things at you.
Very true. We knew we'd get some new things, and that's always the key thing.
All right. But you're going to the ball game in pretty good shape, health-wise. You got Bernadine back, although not Terry Williams.
Yeah, we're missing Terry Williams, and we're also missing Jim Bucco, who injured himself Thursday at practice.
All right. So the Aztecs are leading Texas El Paso at San Diego State. It's also the final home game for San Diego State for a lot of seniors, the final appearance. We'll have the opening kickoff of that ball game right after this.
Thinking about the Riviera, but just don't have the time? Why do you think the people of San Diego chose Mr. A? San Diego Magazine's 1981 poll. As the number one restaurant in San Diego, there'd be the atmosphere created by the combination of excellent service, continental cuisine with an aura of elegance, or the wine list with over 300 varieties to choose from, or perhaps the breathtaking view of the San Diego skyline. Go ahead, impress yourself. Why not, Mr. A? Fortuna-owned restaurant where food and service are considered art.
The Coke Machine. It serves ice-cold, refreshing Coca-Cola. Hardly ever runs out. We call this the Coke machine, too. 12 cans of Coke in one easy-to-carry pack. And it usually costs less than 2 6-packs. It slips neatly into your refrigerator. 12 cans chilled together, but pop out one by one. And if you want a choice, meet the Tab machine. It's right next to the Coke machine. In your stores now.
And this first quarter of action being brought to you in part by Budweiser. Aztec fans, for all you do, this Bud's for you. By Ball Olds Honda, the mile of cars, National City. Texas El Paso will kick off. The Aztecs will receive, start the ballgame. There you see Bill Smith and Donnie Roberts awaiting the kickoff. It is a short one, bounds at the 15. It goes out of bounds. And Donnie Roberts lets it go out.
Kick is out of bounds.
Out. It'll be a 5-yard penalty against Miners of UTEP. And a kickoff again from the 35-yard line. All right. Good luck. His team is 1-8 right now. Aztecs are 5-4. But the Holiday Bowl here in this stadium, later on in December, we'll have BYU against Washington State. That's Scott Waddell ready to kick off again for the Miners. He boots this one. A little better kick. And that is Phil Smith at the 11, 15, 20. Finds a small 25, tries to get outside and does. 30, he's at the 40, still running. It's a block to 50. Miners finally get it at the 48-yard line. Gilbert Allen making the stop. Bill Smith, a fine run back. Bill, one of the best kickoff returners in the WAC. And there you see, as you'll watch it again, Donnie Roberts out in front of him.
The key to a good kickoff return is your blocking and your timing on it. Bill Smith here is waiting. He sees it's clogged up in the middle, and he has the speed and quickness to get outside. He runs a 4-4-40, and there he takes off. Donnie Roberts throwing a block there, but this wasn't enough room on the sidelines for him to get around.
Miners 47, first down. Aztecs go through the pass on first down. Screen. Craig Ellis has blockers. 45 outside of the 40. Still running. 35. Continues downfield inside the 25-yard line. Craig Ellis finally brought down by Brian Kern of Texas El Paso. The Miners show a three-man front. They like to show a 3-4 defense. Big yardage on that play and a screen pass to Craig Ellis. 23 yards. First down Aztecs. Texas El Paso has a couple of outstanding players on defense. Outside linebacker Melvin Vessis, number 35, and linebacker Raymond Morris, number 37. He'll see them a lot tonight. First and 10, Aztecs at the 24, the Miners. Kobler, back to pass on first down, fires out, incomplete. Intended for tight end John Jessup. Covered by linebacker Raymond Morris, so they got Jessup single up on a linebacker, but overthrown. Second and 10.
See a shot of Phil Smith and Doug Scovel. Still bringing it in play.
Aztecs and the Miners meet for the eighth time in history. San Diego State leads the series 6-1, losing only once. That was at El Paso in 1978. Last year down in El Paso, the Aztecs won 28-7. Shotgun this time for both of the Aztecs. Matt Pass. They're blitzing. He fires out and a one-on-one. Darius Sherman takes it. At the 12, steps out of bounds. Right in front of cornerback Rodney Pruitt. And that'll be a first down, San Diego State.
Aztecs doing a good job picking up the blitz. Durham running a good pattern, a deep out. Matt just throws right on. He had Pruitt beat pretty badly. Good pass, good pattern, good protection by that front wall.
Darius Durham, Aztecs leading receiver. Coming into the ballgame with 48, now 49 receptions. Aztecs with a first and 10 at the 11-yard line of Texas El Paso. Kofler, long count, straight back to pass. Sets up, looks at the end zone now, fires over there, complete Durham, touchdown Aztecs.
Made it look real easy. Very good drive by the Aztecs.
And that's another $100 from Dave Ball and a Ball Oldsmobile Honda. The Aztec Athletic Foundation, and I was impressed at Matt's calmness and waiting, as you'll see here, as Durham, there was two safeties in the end zone, and Durham just cut right in front of him.
Matt coming to the outside, he's just waiting for Darius. Finally gets open, he drills the ball right on the numbers. There's a good pass. Matt could do that all the time if he has the protection.
Well, Darius Durham receiving for his seventh touchdown pass of the year. They fire on that. The extra point out of the hold of Mike Jeslin. He holds the ball, bad snap, but the kick is on its way. Nice hold by Jeslin. Has to get the point. So it is 7-0. San Diego State, we played less than a minute, and we'll be back right after this. It's a official. Ball Old Honda's number one in sales in San Diego with over 2,000 Hondas and Oldsmobiles sold in 1981. So, Ball is holding a special one-time-only number one sale in all 1982 Hondas and Oldsmobiles. Now you can own America's number one selling domestic car, the Olds Cutlass, at sensational new low prices during Ball Old's number one sale. 2,000 San Diegans can't be wrong. You always get a better deal at Ball Old's Honda on the National City Mile of Cars.
Really sorry, Joe. Change in plan. I decided to go.
Brent! Oh, I went fishing? When you want to go fishing, you want to go fishing. Mercury Outboard dealers are experts on fishing engines.
Right. Don't miss the Outboard Motor Sale going on now. Nuttall Styrus, your authorized Mercury dealer, 1625 Newton Avenue, downtown San Diego, at the foot of 16th Street.
47 yards in four plays. Myers kickoff. Covered out on the weights and scoops it up to 5, 10, 15. Looking for the blocker. Has a hole. He fumbles. Loose ball. And he has taken it. That's the way to start a ball game. Number 21, Dave Kudup, recovering the fumble. Get right there. It'd be nice for the Aztec to jump out to a big league for a change instead of having to worry about it. There's a kick, a split kick by Myers, sort of rolls down there. Allen picking it up. And here the ball just sort of slipped right out of his hands. Took a good shot there by number 42,
Leo Ramos.
Defensive back. All right, so the Aztecs now better jump on top of the Miners. Incidentally, Delbert Allen of UTEP is one of the better kickoff returners in the country. Whack. First out of the 24, go for the pass. Three-man pattern looking now, rolls out, dumps it out to Craig Ellis, 25, and he slips. A wet grass goes down at the 23-yard line as Craig circling out of the backfield to begin that pass. Nice one-handed grab. Matchup presence might not to force the ball in for an interception, but the throw-out is one of his release valves, and that was Ellis out there.
No gain for the second down 10 Aztecs.
There's the offensive brain trust to the Aztecs. Scoble and Featherstone and Atkins and Tom Freeman.
Second down, Coker sets his club. Back, straight back to pass again. Four-man rush. Fires over the middle. Just 10. The 5 to the 4-yard line. Safety man, Billy McCormick. John Jessup. In the tight end position with his 25th reception of the year. Here it is.
Straight drop back by Matt. Jessup just go down and turn in his zone. Hits that seam. Matt throws the ball right on the numbers. Just take it. And John's had a terrific senior season. He had a great career, too, as a tight end here at San Diego State.
Indeed. Just from up the road at Tustin. So the Aztecs now knocking on the door again. First down, goal to go at the 4-yard line. First running play, hands off Ellis at 5-3, goes in, touchdown Aztecs.
How easy it is.
All right, Craig Ellis. That's his second touchdown of the year.
Just a lead play, pulling guard. Pullback lead, given to the halfback, and he just cuts in wherever he sees an opening. Very simple play, well executed by the Aztecs.
Boy, nice lead block by Donnie Roberts. He's springing. So Dave Meyer on to try the extra point out of the hole to Mike Jesler. The Aztecs lead of 13-0. Ball is down. It's on its way. It is perfect. Just like that. Aztecs jump on top of UTEP, taking advantage of a fumble. They also cost the Aztecs another, or get the Aztecs $100 from Dave Ball, and it's 14-0. We'll be back right after this.
This would be something comfortable. The San Diego Hilton, close on a private beach. Biker jog around the bed. Play tennis. Unwind in the jacuzzi. Dine gourmet style in the Trade Winds restaurant. Relax at the cargo bar. Our gala ballroom is a city favorite for gala dinners, banquets, and meetings. The San Diego Hilton, where you can do it all or do nothing at all. It's your pleasure.
This butts to the people who make the tough jobs all part of a day's work.
This butts for you. distinctly the clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
This Bud's for you.
Let's go back to the play. San Diego State on offense. Aztecs lead 14-0. Miners again short blitz. From the shotgun, Holder back to pass. They'll run it out of there. Midfield, 45, 40, 35. Still running at the 30 to the 27. Finally hauled down by Kevin Ward as Matt runs for 19 yards and a first down. Mr. Total Offense.
Sure is. Once again, Matt showing his versatility. Can't find a wide receiver. Field's wide open. He just takes off. Matt has the speed to be able to do it. He's just running right now. Here comes Ward, number 18, and sort of corral him. It was a good pickup by Matt, keeping the drive alive.
The Aztecs, again, are in UTEP territory at the Miners' 28-yard line. The first and 10, they show wing formation for the first time tonight. Gives straight ahead. Robert Small breaks through at 25, 20, still running at the 20, and as continues to dive down to the 15 to the 14. Boy, Donnie Roberts on a hot roll now.
He sure is. He played well the last couple of weeks, and last week was his best effort as an Aztec back. He finally started getting the ball, both receiving-wise and... He's just straight ahead blocking. There's a number 68, Kevin Howell, pulling guard, cuts the... Pulls around the trap, opens the hole for Roberts, and he just takes off. It's a good piece of running. Good individual effort. Breaking tackles and struggling for extra yardage.
Another first down, San Diego State at the 14 of UTEP. Booker looks over the defense of the Miners. Pat will put it up. Pressure, dumps it out. Screen, Roberts, 15, the 10. Cuts back in at the 5. Touchdown, Aztec. Tonight, and here it is again as this play will cost Dave Ball another $100.
Little flick. Roberts does a great job here. He sets up the block so that Matt Long, number 56, comes in. You see Donnie going to the outside. He's setting up number 37, Morris. Long takes him out. Roberts cuts back in for a touchdown. Done that easily.
Donnie Roberts scoring his first touchdown of the night. Bookler's second touchdown pass. It's now 20. Nothing. Dave Meyer to try the extra point out of the hold of Jeslin. Ball is down. Kick is on its way. And it's good. So we still have 8:25 to play in the first quarter, and it's 21-0. San Diego State. Dave Meyer to kick off again. Back deep. Martin. And... It's going to be Allen. At the goal line, he'll run it back to the 5. Go laterally, get a handoff to Martin. He's got blockers for 10, 20, a lot of blockers, 30, 40, 50, Aztec territory, and the 20 finally knocked out of bounds. Charlie Davis on the reverse, sucked the Aztecs in and got a big run back.
Great run back, we'll see it here, Allen. Looks like he's been taking the ball to the left side, gives it back. The Aztecs were in good pursuit. Davis just has a wide open field. You can see him running. There's nobody in sight for a while. Number 40, Mark Coleman will come to your picture right here. Trying to run him down, but Davis has that speed. Just keeps going. Diving effort.
Finally knocked out about 84 yards on that return. First and 10 at the 16-yard line for UTEP. Jim Riley, the quarterback. First down, handoff to Copeland. He's at the 10 to the 5. Now check that, Delbert Thompson. Delbert Thompson, their tailback. You take a look now at a very tired Charlie Davis.
Excellent run back. Number 20. Your bread and butter play the trap up the middle. Belcher doing the trapping and Thompson doing the running.
12 yards.
So the Miners of UTEP stopped the last time they had the ball. Now it's a big opportunity. First and goal at the 4-yard line. Robert Thompson, their top rusher, averaging 4.3 per carry. And the eye formation now, there's a 5. Thompson lining up with fullback Greg Adams. This will be Adams at the 3 to the 2-yard line.
Stopped number 28, Greg Adams, the ball carrier.
Bottom of the mile, Doug Reed, Kevin Ritchie.
On the tackle, Kevin
on the board.
Ritchie for the Aztecs.
Fullback Rick Adams, 28. 5'11", 190, a freshman out of Odessa, Texas. The ball at the 1 yard line. Second down, goal to go. Miners, as a team, are averaging 12 and a half points per ball game. Slot formation left. Riley Thompson tries to dive in, but is denied. The Aztecs stop him. Now check that, Adam. That was fullback Adams. Tried to dive in. There's Jerome Craney at the bottom of the pile.
Good surge by the Aztec defensive line. Beat UTEP's offense to the ball. As you can see it right here, they stack it up. They're all pinching down. The linebackers doing what they're supposed to, meeting the back right at the top of his league.
There's Todd Seabaugh, top of the pile. Well, they give him forward progress of an inch or two. So it is now third down, half a yard to go. Base is wide left in the slot is Allen. And quarterback sneak, Jeff Riley, quarterback, looks to be in as they stack it up. No indication yet from the officials. Now they say it is a touchdown. Took them a while to sort it out. Oh, Jeff Riley, quarterback sneak, goes in for the touchdown. And Texas El Paso gets on the board.
Big play being the kickoff return, the reverse. 84 yards, put him in good field position.
So, special teams coach Gary Zahner, I'm sure not thrilled about that. 84-yard return against them. Longest of the year against the Aztecs.
UTEP probably never showed it all year, and they've had 2 weeks to prepare for this ball game. So I'm sure we'll see a lot of gimmicks from them. They have nothing to lose. They already have a losing season. They might as well just pull out all stops.
Have some fun.
Have some fun.
Scott Waddell to try the extra point, and a now 21-6 ball game kick is on its way. Lefty puts it through. So now it is 21-7 as the Miners get on the board. There you see the score, 21-7. Aztecs lead it. We'll be back right after this.
They're smoking hot. Smokey Gaines and his Aztecs are going to burn up the court with All-American candidate Michael Cage, plus high-scoring Zach Jones, averaging over 17 points a game. And here's a hot deal on Aztec basketball season tickets. A free pair of men or women's Nike all-court shoes from Second Soul with every $80 season ticket you buy. Get your Aztec tickets at any Second Soul store, Stadium Gate F, or call 283-7096. San Diego State University Aztec.
On the 4 o'clock movie, it's a titanic battle for survival in Destroy All Monsters Week. Monday at 4, see Dr. Cyclops. Tuesday, man faces a cosmic colossus in Destroy All Monsters. Don't miss Return of the Giant Monsters Wednesday. Thursday at 4, it's King Kong versus Godzilla. And Friday, see the incredible two-headed transplant. Destroy All Monsters, this week on the 4 o'clock movie.
Let's go back to the play. San Diego State on offense. On the 38-yard line. Last drive started at 39. Bolfer will start this series out of the shotgun. At back to pass. Sets up. He's going long. Darius Durham takes it in at the 25. Falls forward to the 21. Battling Mike Brown, the safety. And Darius is out leaking. All right.
Good pass by Matt. It was right on the money. Darius, keeping his eye on the ball, not worrying about the defender, makes the catch. See, Matt is going deep all the way. Left it fly.
Yeah, Durham just go down and run under it.
Run under it. He's running the post, fighting Mike Brown. Good catch, watching right in. Number 4, Mike Brown. His dad does a lot of officiating in the WAC basketball conference.
He's the head of officials, the basketball officials, right? Durham Brown, in fact, he's the only good official in the WAC basketball.
That's in football, too.
In football, there are none. All right, at the 22, first down, Coker to pass again. Has time now, flushed out of there, dumps another screen. Craig Ellis this time, looking for blocker, 20. Down to the 15-yard line. As Craig got hemmed in, ran out of running room, but carries the football for 6-7 yards. We're being hit down by Raymond Morris.
Screen has been a very valuable weapon tonight because UTEP is playing that zone and they're dropping everybody really deep, so they're just dumping it out. They want to draw the linebackers up, then they're going to start hitting the intermediate passes. But right now they have the UTEP defense between a rock and a hard place. They really don't know how to play it.
So with 5 minutes to play in the first quarter, Aztecs lead 21-7. Starting to get more as they have the ball at the 15 at UTEP with a second down and 3. Slot formation left. Kofler gives Donnie Roberts hole up the middle as the flag goes down, and Donnie dives straight ahead to the 11-yard line where he's upended by linebacker Raymond Morris for what looks to be first down yardage, but as I say, hold everything, there is a penalty flag.
Could
first
be a little
of the night.
Motion. Little motion probably by the Aztecs.
I think either Phil Smith or Darius Durham jumped too quickly. Yeah, the flanker.
Illegal procedure.
That'll cost him 5 yards and a first down. Walk off to the 20-yard line.
5 yards, takes the ball back.
They're going to bring up now a second down and 8. As Vince Warren, the freshman, checks into the lineup in place of Clinton Sampson. Vince, very impressive at Las Vegas a week ago. He sets up wide right. Bill Smith wide left with Darius Durham in the slot to the left. Hopler on second down. That will put it up. Turn, fires, slant in. Warren overthrow. Coverage by Mike Brown, a safety, and also Grant, another safety. As he looked to the slot side of the field and then came back the other way to Vince Warren, a freshman out of Albuquerque.
Little page out of the UTEP offense. Three wide out. Four tight end.
Well, they could be fast. We'll bring up a third. And 8-4 San Diego State. Aztecs lead 21-7. On third down from the 20-yard line, UTEP showing blitz. Draw by Colter. Quarterback draw, but couldn't get free as Matt stepped back, started to run up the middle. A good defensive play by Herman Whiting, an outside linebacker, a 6'2 junior out of Houston. Kopler hit down. I wouldn't really call that a sack. I'd just say, in my terminology, that'd be lost trying to run. Looks to me like it's a quarterback draw.
See 97, the nose guard coming right off the block of Matt Long. It's supposed to be a screen pass, and you see the lineman coming down to the bottom towards the bottom half of your screen. It was a good play by nose guard, number 97, Matt Long.
Aztecs hold it for a field goal try. From the 30, a 40-yard attempt by Dave Meyer right in the middle of the field. Good spot ball that's on its way, and it is good. Out of his slump, Dave Meyer. As the Aztecs fans some broad stand, they came out to greet Dave Myers. Had a tough time the last couple of weeks. That's 3 points. That makes it 24-7. Aztecs get 3 points out of it. And we still have 3:43 to play in the first quarter. We'll be back right after this.
Get the tap.
Ready for some excellent service in an intimate Western atmosphere? It's El Cajon's Bull and Bear, where the emphasis is on good food. Try our delicious salad bar, seafood or prime rib, or the house specialty, rack of lamb. There's a children's menu and nightly entertainment. The downtown San Diego Bull and Bear caters to the business person, with luncheon specials, happy hour from 4 to 7, lots of convenient parking, or plan your next party here, too. Now, if you're in the mood for some good food and entertainment, the Aspen Mine Company has it all on El Cajon Boulevard. All are fine Fortuna-owned restaurants. As we resume play, Texas El Paso. On the attack. Riley will put it up. Back to pass, fires, and it is intercepted by San Diego State. Jerome Franey, the linebacker. Intended for Delbert Allen, but there's a flag down, so hold everything. Let's hold everything here. See if it might be holding against UTEP. Pat Sweeney, referee, local man, goes up at the Oceanside. Double check. Lead holding UTEP. Aztecs, I'm sure, will say thanks, but no thanks. So another turnover as Mr. Franey out of Bakersfield comes up with the interception.
First of the year.
His first of the year. All right. The Aztecs intercept Jeff Riley. First and 10, San Diego State. Leading in the ball game, 24-7. There's Matt Kopler. 13 seconds left to play in the first period. The Aztecs have pretty good field position at their own 30-yard line. Matt sets up in the shotgun on first down. Three wideouts. And Matt will put up. They're blitzing. They're coming. Matt has time, though. Fires. Long. Clint Sampson. Intercepted. And... yes, held. Nice play defensively by Mike Brown, the safety. But there's a flag down.
I think it, Aztecs are called, will be called for holding, so the interception will stand up.
So Matt going for the bundle. Long one to Clint Sampson, which is in essence like a punt. As the ball intercepted at the 33-yard line. Take a look at it. Maybe we can see the holding.
See Matt back there. Can't see the holding. It happened early in the line. Matt just lets it go. Sampson running that post pattern. Brown coming over from his pre-safety spot, making a nice play.
That's his first of the year. That's only the ninth interception of the year by UTEP. Conversely, the Aztecs at 14, at 15 now. On first down, Roddy option. Comes out to the corner, turns in himself as the Aztecs, Rick Reeder, did a good job of taking the pitch man. Roddy forced to keep the ball, and he gets a couple of yards. He's hammered down by Bill Fairbrother.
Reeder did an excellent job. He didn't commit. He waited there until the last possible moment, forcing Riley to take the ball himself. Plus, he gave enough time for the rest of the pursuing Aztec defenders to come over and help him out.
That's the end of the first quarter. 24-7 is our score. One quarter in the books, three to come. We'll be back right after this.
The end of destination begins with a victory.
Hey, Gene, let's see if the Dolphins still want company at the lake.
Too late, Dad.
The McGraw's going boating.
Yes.
Great.
Next week. Mother, you can.
With your own boat, you go when you want to. Mercury Outboard dealers are experts in boating fun.
Don't miss the outboard motor sale going on now. Nuttall Styrus, your authorized Mercury dealer, 1625 Newton Avenue, downtown San Diego, at the foot of 16th Street.
This bud's for that first day on the job.
This bud's for you. All you can do.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do.
This Bud's for you.
All right, first play of the second quarter. Riley to pass. Rolls out. Looks downfield. Has a man wide open at the 30. Taking it in is Jones. He's at the 20. At the 5. And goes in for a touchdown. Kenny Jones. Touchdown, UTEP.
Boy, he was wide open. All by himself. There had to be a blown coverage over there. Bradley showed he has an arm himself. He let that ball go and let it fly.
Boy,
what more can you say about that? It had to be a blown coverage because nobody is that wide open.
Well, UTEP. 64 yards. 66 yards. Touchdown pass.
Number six,
Doc Waddell. Makes it 24-13. Waddell to try the extra point. It's on its way. And it is good.
Well,
just like
good.
That, the Miners get the bomb. And it's 24-14. And we've only played 11 seconds of the second quarter. In the second quarter, brought to you in part by Budweiser. For Aztec fans, for all you do, this butt's for you. And by Ball Olds Honda, a mile of cars, National City. With Bob Babbage, this is Ron Rena at San Diego Stadium, final home game. As Waddell will kick off now for UTEP. This will be Bill Smith at the 9-yard line. 15, running laterally back to Donnie Roberts. 20, cuts in. Anybody looking for running room? Has open field. Cuts in to 30. Now tries to go outside in the foot race. 35. 40, it's a block, 45, 50, still running, and finally hemmed in, chased out of bounds in UTEP territory, the 42-yard line, Darnell Graham.
And Phil Smith having a great night returning kickoffs today. I'd like to see what his average is right now. He's had three outstanding kickoff returns tonight.
His shortest one's been 33 yards, that one 54.
And he does it all on his own. He's trying to get to the outside. You see right here, there's nowhere to go. Now he comes back. This is all on his own ability. Puts a good move on. Breaks out to the outside. He has the speed and ability to be able to outrun a lot of people. He's doing it right here. He just runs out of real estate. Knocked out of bounds, but a fine 54-yard return.
First down, Aztecs. Miners, 42-yard line. Kopler out of the shotgun. Three-man rush. Matt over the middle. Fires complete. Durham, 30, 25. Darius to the 17-yard line. Tackled by Darnell Graham. Boy, Darius Durham wide open. Took in his third pass of the night.
On the tackle, number 31, Darnell.
Phil Smith came into the game fourth in the WAC in kickoff returns, averaging 22 yards a return.
The leader is Reggie Wilson of Utah, 28.
So he could catch him tonight. We see a shot at Darius coming over the middle, wide open. Knocked down by 31. Darnell Grant, a cornerback.
Aztecs for the first down at the 18-yard line. Durham, four catches tonight, 100 yards. He's got 52 balls on the season. Aztecs from slot formation left. Over the pass. Fired out. Quick to fifth floor. And incomplete. Knocked away. And a fine defensive play by Darnell Grant. Now that's a good defensive play. He just punched it out.
Did a great job. He reacted up and drove through the receiver. Hit the ball. Knocked it out of Vincent's hand. It was a good pass by Matt. He threw it before Warren made the cut, and the ball was right there, but Darnell Grant making a fine play.
That'll bring up now a second attempt for San Diego State. Aztecs on top, 24-14. We still have 14 minutes to play in the half. Aztecs show eye formation for the first time tonight. Kofler rolls left, looks upfield, turns, fires back the other way. Durham takes it in at the, no, Sampson, at the two-yard line. Nice play, Clint Sampson.
Beautiful catch. He had Darnell Grant all over his back. I thought maybe it'd be an interference call.
And right in front of Darnell Grant is right.
Get another shot at it. Matt with the semi-roll to the weak side and looking back to the strong side where coming across the middle there, you see Grant all over him. He didn't catch the ball. It was interference.
Oh, look how great he caught it. He bobbled it and caught it on his back.
Great concentration by Clint.
Good shot by our cameraman. Donnie Roberts at the two, at the one, and denied the goal line. Donnie in traffic down there, trying to punch it in, a little short of the goal line.
Gain of 1 yard. Second down.
Rich Moran with a helping hand. Rich doing a good job at point guard, moving over from center. So the Aztecs now have second and goal at the 1 yard line. Aztecs split backs this time. Kofler on second down. Quarterback sneak. Matt dives in. Gets it himself. All right, so Matt Kofler dives in for the touchdown. To make it 30-14, Aztecs, and Matt cost Dave Ball another $100 for the Aztec Athletic Foundation.
That's a pretty safe call. Here he goes behind Matt Long, Rich Moran, and Daryl Yarbrough, number 66, and those are three pretty fine offensive football players there. So Matt had no trouble getting into the end zone.
His seventh touchdown of the season, and this is the 10th game. And Dave Meyer on to try the extra point. On the hold of Mike Jeslin. Now 30-14 contest. Ball is down, kicks on its way, and it's good enough. Oh, it's now a 31-14 ball game. Aztecs lead it. We have played 2 minutes in the second quarter. We'll be back with more right after this. It's official. Ball is go back to the play. San Diego State on offense. First down, Aztecs. Yeah, Roberts breaks one tackle, trying to get outside. 20, 25, still running, breaks it. He's at the 40, has a man hanging on, and Donnie gives him a ride to the 46-yard line. Junior out of Temple City, Donnie Roberts. Donnie tackled from behind by linebacker Raymond Morris. A 28-yard run for Donnie.
Good effort. He had a good block by Craig Ellis. But the blitzing linebacker coming in, Craig sort of sends him down to the inside right there. Johnny sidestep it, and there's no support on the outside. He just takes it off. Out running a cornerback, McCormick, and finally Morris, linebacker, grabbing it by the shirt tail. Johnny keeps his legs going, and picks up a few extra.
First down at 46-yard line, Aztecs. Kofler rolls right, looks downfield, looking for Darius Durham. Chase now loses the ball, and luckily the Aztecs recover. Oh, very unhappy. Melvin Bessis, number 35 there, hoped he could get it. Who came up with that?
Matt Long, the center, number 56.
Matt just flat out watched it.
Here comes Bessis, 30.
Morris chasing him down.
And Bessis is right there in front of him, and the ball just bounces, hits right off of Bessis' leg. And there's Matt Long.
Matt, the junior out of Ventura. That's a 6-yard loss. Aztecs now at the 40-yard line have a second and 16. They'll operate out of the shotgun. Matt doesn't like the alignment, so had to foul it up. He was trying to get somebody to shift or move. Couldn't get that word across, so he calls a timeout. Aztecs take the time. It's 4:15 to play in a half, and they lead it 31-14. Aztec basketball coming up next Friday night. Smoky Canes, Aztec Cagers will open their season at home at Peterson Gym against UC Santa Barbara Gauchos.
And today, this afternoon, they had a big red and black scrimmage.
They did. So the Aztecs are ready for the basketball season with high hopes. And basketball season tickets are available now at the Aztec Ticket Office, 283-7096, 283-7096. Or at the Aztec Ticket Office at San Diego Stadium. Or also at the Sportsman's Cup Box Office. But this next Friday night's opener, night after Thanksgiving, against Santa Barbara, is at Peterson Gym.
Basketball season opened today. College basketball.
Yeah, the Hall of Fame game. Beat Virginia today.
And Virginia beat them 63-61. So it's a good ballgame.
Well,
I believe Ralph is out, isn't he?
He had a groin injury. He was supposed to try to play a little bit today. I didn't see any story on it, just that raw score. Of course, the BYU football team will be headed here to this stadium to play in the Holiday Bowl against Washington State.
Cougar Bowl.
It is the Cougar Bowl. Boy, you got that right. Second and 16, Aztec. Again, out of the shotgun. Matt will put it up. Three-man rush. Matt looks downfield. Fires for Smith. Smith. Phil has it at the 40. And tripped up right there. Rodney Pruitt making the play defensively. That's 20 yards on first down.
The middle's been open all evening, and they're hitting that crossing pattern. Matt just waiting for it to come open. Throws it in. Right on the numbers. Smith making the catch, and Pruitt putting a good hit on him. Beat number 23, Bill McCormick, strong safety closing in.
At the 41-yard line, it is a first and 10, San Diego State. Wing formation this time. Well, setback is Roberts. And Donnie, the ball carry-off. Left tackle has a hole, 35, 30-yard line. Don Roberts with 11 yards and a first down. Stop made by Billy McCormick, who Coach Billy Alton says is their best secondary performer. He's 6'1", a freshman. From Finleyville, Pennsylvania, the best man on the secondary. He's a freshman.
A good block here by Darrell Yarbrough and Brian Skade. There's Yarbrough and Skade double teaming, opening that hole. A lot of running room. Running backs like to see that big hole in there.
Donnie piling up big yards in the ground tonight. First and 10, Aztecs with 3:27 to play in a half. Matt will put this one up. Blitz is on. Sets up a screen. Ellis, running room. Breaks a tackle, 25, 20, and finally bumped out of bounds. That was all Craig Ellis. Finally knocked out by Rodney Pruitt. That's a fine running by Craig Ellis.
Carried out of bounds on a tackle by number 9, Rodney Pruitt.
Boy, he made great effort. Nothing.
Great effort. Juggled the ball, turned around, broke a tackle. I think he broke Melvin Bess's tackle. Melvin's one of the best linebackers they have. See the big rush. Matt throws it out. Juggle here. And there it is, Melvin, number 35.
Boy, Rich Moran just hammered that guy.
Good block.
Darius Durant, shadow blocking. First and 10, Aztec. Donnie Roberts against Mahomes, works through it, makes something out of it as he pounds his way down to the 10-yard line. And Donnie, so doing, gets 7 yards.
Right, he's filling in for Bull Williams, who's injured. He has to pull the hamstring muscle, and he's doing a pretty good job at pullback. What a great game last week, 95 yards, I believe, rushing. And the way he's running today, he may surpass that total.
Indeed. He's well over 50, 60 yards now. It is second down and 3, Aztecs. 2:47 to play and a half. They lead 31-14. Kofler under center. Roberts again, left side. Same play. Don pounds his way down there to the 7, maybe the 6-yard line for what looks to be close to a first down. Out of the pile. UTEP, Salter, also Wayne Matson.
He's coming back from injury.
They're calling for a major.
They're going to bring the chains in. Close enough for that. And the measurement. Oh, just short. Donnie Roberts tonight, 65 yards already on 6 carries. That's better than 10 yards per carry.
Pretty good average.
So, third and less than a yard for San Diego State.
Put the ball on the 7. Just third down.
Well, Vince Warren comes in, sets up wide left, puts Sampson to the right.
Setbacks are Roberts and Ellis. Kofler on third down. He'll keep it himself. Matt, quarterback sneak.
Quarterback.
Back at Matt Long.
Keeping the ball.
Dives in there for first down yardage. William Pyle, the ball will be placed at the six. And that is a first down, San Diego State. All right, so they got the drive going now at the six-yard line with a first and goal to go, leading 31-14. Going to add some points. Durham sits out to the left. Sampson to the right. On first down. Blitz. Fake handoff. Dumps it out. Darius Durham. No, Craig Ellis. Touchdown after. All right, Craig Ellis. Senior takes in the pass for a touchdown. And San Diego State, with 2:02 to play and a half, adds another 6 points to make it 37-14.
Good drive by the Aztecs, mixing up the passing with the running. Donnie Roberts doing all the work on the ground. Ellis getting the final 7 yards through the air.
Second touchdown tonight for Craig, one by rushing, now one by pass receiving.
Number 12, Dave Meyer, in quite a point.
Dave Meyer's been a very busy man tonight.
Got
to add the point. Got a hold of Mike Jeslin. Ball is on its way. And it's perfect.
And the kick is good.
So with 2:02 to play in the first half of tonight's game, it is San Diego State 38. The Aztec just went 82 yards in 10 plays. A short pass, Kofler to Ellis for the touchdown. So they lead it by a score of 38-14 as Dave Meyer kicks off. Charlie Davis awaits it at the 7, 10, 15, 20. As you get outside, missed by one man, missed by another man, and they have him in, knock him out of bounds, 26-yard line.
Senior Bob Levine, number 26, first to hit him, slowed him down, knocked him out of bounds.
All right, Bob, a senior from Birmingham, Michigan. His parents are here to see his final home game. And living in Michigan, this is only about the third or fourth time they've ever seen him play over his four-year career at San Diego State.
With the weather back there, I bet they're glad to be out here.
And yeah, his parents in Michigan. Appreciate that.
Here's another shot of the touchdown drive. Ellis coming out of the backfield. Coverage was missed by number 36, the linebacker, Goins.
On first down, Riley to pass. Fires. Incomplete. Then for Jerry Jones as Vernon Dean tried to step in front of him and bat it away. And might have deflected it a little bit or he spotted him.
Hindered his vision, broke up his concentration.
So the incomplete pass by Riley will bring up a second and 10. Aztecs lead 38-14. You're questioning their previous high. Well, they scored 52 against Iowa State. On second down, Riley will put it up again. Has time now, flushed out of there, pressured by Vance, and throws. Nicely completes it at the 30. And to the 35-yard line is Eric Anderson, freshman wide receiver from El Paso. So that'll be 10 yards, no, 9 yards, not quite a first down. So it's third and one. UTEP trying to hurry now. The clock moving, minute 28 to go. Riley calls a play. Quarterback sneaks it, gets the first down. He goes to the 36-yard line. So that'll stop the clock for a moment while they move the chains. Roddy can call a play and get his club set as he has a first and 10. First and 10, Texas El Paso Aztecs at 12 on the field, but the officials didn't see it. Roddy now cranks up the fire, and it's incomplete at the 43-yard line. 10 for Kelvin May, as Vernon Dean was there. Now that'll stop the clock for a moment. George Williams, a safety, was trying to get off the field.
He didn't get off, really.
He was about a yard still on, but he was going full blast. So I think the officials just kind of turned their head the other way. Second and 10, UTEP. Minute 14 left to play as Billy Alton, Miners head man, Ackerman head man, looks on. UTEP, Riley sets up. Pressured, rolling out of there, flag down. He fires a duck that is almost, or is it intercepted? No, not quite.
Not quite.
Kenny Jones, the intended receiver. And who was that almost intercepted?
Number 26.
Bob Levine. All right. Bobby had to pick one up.
That may have been the ugliest pass we've seen all year. Oh, it was tipped.
Okay.
I apologize. It was tipped by one of the linemen.
No wonder it was ugly.
Meanwhile, there's a flag down, and it's holding, indicated against UTEP. See the indication here. And decline. Oh, Pat's talking up a storm. So that means with the incomplete pass, the Miners will have a second attempt. 1:06 remaining on the clock. UTEP has had three turnovers, intercepted once, fumbling twice. Well, officials still thrashing it out.
Trying to figure out who is holding.
Aztecs decline it.
Well, they marked off the penalty automatically, and then the Aztecs finally told them, well, we don't want to take it. We'll take it down.
So, yeah, that makes sense. You have to be a rocket scientist to figure that out.
But we're dealing with whack officials.
Ah, yeah, it says it all right there. So it is third and 10. The Aztecs take the advancement of the down. 1:06 to play. Riley setting his club on third down. Long count. Takes the draw, back the pass, trying to set up the screen. Pressured, getting out of there. Looking upfield, running it. 35, 40. And a lot of black shirts converge on him. He fumbles as he's hit. Loose ball. And boy, that ball was touched by a lot of people. Rolls into Aztec territory, the 48-yard line. About 5 yards upfield from where the tackle occurred. Who recovered? No indication yet. San Diego State. Rick McReeder. Rick, a senior from Visalia. Oh, poor Jeff Riley, pressured here. Sees all those black shirts.
Nowhere to go. Breaks the tackle there. Doug Reed, number 60, takes off. Going to get blindsided here. Right here by one of the...
I think that's Doug Reed coming back. No.
No, that was Todd Seabaugh, number 53.
There's the football. Ultimately recovered by San Diego State after being kicked around a lot. First down, Aztecs at their own 49-yard line, 52 seconds to go. Can they score again before the half? Colfer will put it up and try. Got a blitz, dumps it off. Nice catch, Durham. Running ladder, trying to get out of bounds at 45. Gets not only out of bounds, but I believe he got a first down. Yes. Chased out by Darnell Grant.
Good play by Durham. Used his head on that. Wanted to get out of bounds, but he also wanted to pick up the first down. He did a very good job.
Stops the clock with 44 seconds to play. Aztecs in Miner territory. Darius with 5 or 6 catches tonight. 5.
Shot at the scoreboard, and that tells the whole story. 38-14 Aztecs.
That is 16 for 23 tonight. We'll put it up again. Blitz. Matt has time. Delivers. Complete. Sampson at the 19-yard line. Nice leaping catch by Clint Sampson. In front of Brant Goins. Another first down Aztecs. 39 seconds to go, so they're in scoring territory.
Making the tackle on Sampson, number 36.
Sampson out of Los Angeles.
First down.
And now I believe the Aztecs will take a timeout and stop that clock. Yes, they do. Wise thing to do is Mack goes over and talks to Doug Scoble. So 39 seconds showing the clock. The Aztecs with the first down at the Miner 20. So they are definitely in scoring position again. With Bob Babbage, this is Ron Rena. 39 seconds to play and a half. Aztecs with a first down at the 20. Colfer out of the shotgun. Blitz by UTEP, but he delivers to Durham. And Darius down to one knee, takes it in. Nice catch at the 6-yard line in front of Darnell Grant.
Great catch, good concentration. That was a hard ball to catch. He was going away from him, he was falling down.
34 seconds to play. Aztecs have a first down, goal to go at the 7-yard line of UTEP. Roberts and Ellis are the setbacks. Kopler on first down. Clock is moving, dumps a pass. Out of the end zone, over Durham's head. Pass to stop the clock. He's obviously in 4-down territory, so no big deal.
Right, nobody was open. He didn't want to use up all the time, so he just threw the ball away. Good play by Matt. He's 18 for 25 now in the first half. This may be his best first half of the season.
Oh, yeah, indeed. 52 yards and 3 touchdowns. So, 26 seconds showing. Aztecs trying to get some more points on the board.
I think they're on their way to breaking their season's best of 52 against Iowa State early in the year.
Indeed. Quick synopsis, if you missed it. Rose Bowl will be Washington and Iowa. Fiesta Bowl, Penn State and USC.
That'll be a good one.
Sugar Bowl, Pittsburgh and Georgia for number one. Cotton Bowl, Texas and Alabama. Orange Bowl, Nebraska and Clemson. Sun Bowl, Oklahoma, who now is 5-4-1 and has a game to go with Oklahoma State. Oklahoma against Houston. Hall of Fame Bowl, Mississippi State against somebody to be named later. Holiday Bowl, BYU, Washington State. Liberty Bowl, Ohio State and Navy. Interesting matchup it is. Gator Bowl, Arkansas, North Carolina. Independence Bowl, Texas A&M and Oklahoma State, who the Aztecs beat earlier this year. All right, here we go. And Aztecs jump. Flags go down as everybody took off before the snap. That'll cost the Aztecs 5 yards. And wrapping it up, Tangerine Bowl, Southern Miss against Missouri.
In the Garden State Bowl, Tennessee.
Tennessee, yeah, of all people, against Wisconsin.
And that'll be a big hit.
Peach Bowl, West Virginia against the upcoming winner, the Florida State-Florida game. I hope you wrote all those down. That's the bowl lineup. 5 yard walk-off. Aztecs put the ball on the 11-yard line. They still have 24 seconds to go, and it is second down. Goal to go. Phil Smith sets out to the right, Durham to the left. In a tight end for the Aztecs now is Tim Lawton, a freshman. First playing in scrimmage. Freshman from Salinas. Kobler, screen, Durham, looks for a block, gets a 10. At the 5, goes down to the 3-yard line. A little slip screen to Darius Durham. They don't get the touchdown, but the Aztecs quickly call timeout with 17 seconds to go as Herman Lurking, outside linebacker, slid through the traffic to make the stop on Darius.
Good block by Darrell Yarbrough, number 66, was the man through the block to screen Darius. Quick slip screen to the wide receiver. They pull the guard, have him kick out on the cornerback, and they leave the rest up to the wide receiver.
So now the Aztecs will have third down, goal to go. Ball resting just inside the 4-yard line as you take a look at the turf of San Diego Stadium. And match. Kofler gets a chance to go and talk to the official. So the Aztecs can easily run a play, and then if they don't get in, go for the field goal in the 17 seconds showing on the clock.
Or they can go for a fake field goal.
Indeed. I don't think it's in the book, but they haven't used it yet.
This would be a good time to use it. If they don't get in, they're ahead by 24. They have nothing to lose.
Why not? All right, the ball they come. 17 seconds remaining. Smith sets up as a wing to the left. Kofler under center, on third down. Matt rolls right, looks to the end zone. Craig Ellis wide open, he didn't see him, so he'll run it. The 3, the 2, and goes close to the ball, and it doesn't quite go in. Boy, Craig Ellis is wide open. Matt didn't see him. Well, now the Aztecs call time. No, UTEP calls timeout. Why? I don't know. That wasn't very smart. Stopped the clock with 4 seconds.
No, it wasn't.
Which helped the Aztecs, so they'll have a chance to try to kick a field goal.
I couldn't believe UTEP called a timeout.
Now, somebody, one of their players, was not very wise.
4 seconds remaining in the half.
So, at the 1-yard line, 4 seconds remaining, the Aztecs have a chance for a field goal attempt.
No, they're calling them off. There's Gary Zahner, special teams coach, calling them off. Matt wants to go for the touchdown.
A little indecision there.
They're going for it.
All right. The 1-yard line, what the heck? This is not for the national championship anyway.
This is true.
So if they don't make it, it won't kill the program.
I'd like to see a fake field goal, though. Something exciting.
Yeah.
Different. What the heck?
All right, so the ball resting at the 1 yard. Here's Matt. Now you can't see Craig Ellis.
Ellis is all by himself in the end zone. Darrell Yarbrough leading him. Look at Darrell chugging along out there.
Oh, boy, he's a dandy.
Matt cutting inside. If he'd have stayed outside, he may have gotten in.
At the 1 yard, Ike Kofler with setbacks Roberts and Ellis. On fourth down, Matt rolls left. Looks to the end zone, fires it out, complete touchdown, Aztecs. Craig Ellis.
Good catch by Ellis. He had to come back for the ball, and he made an excellent catch on it.
All right, so instead of 3, they go for the bundle, and they get it. Oh, Craig Ellis makes a fine catch, and he's getting congratulated by Doug Scoble, the head man. Meyer, with no time remaining, will try to add the extra point as it's now a 44-14 ball game. Aztec's second largest offensive output of the year. Ball is on its way. It's a good pick. So, that's the end of the first half of play, which to a lot of people would be enough for a whole ball game. And as we look at the touchdown again, as Matt Rowe
had it rolling out.
Now he missed Craig Ellis in the last place. He's going to get him this time. There it is. $100.
Great catch.
A ball, the ball, Oldsmobile to the Aztec Athletic Foundation. And that'll do it for the first half of play. You see a happy Craig Ellis. San Diego State 45-14, back after this. It's official. Ball Olds Honda's number one in sales in San Diego with over 2,000 Hondas and Oldsmobiles sold in 1981. So, Ball is holding a special one-time only number one sale in all 1982 Hondas and Oldsmobiles. Now you can own America's number one selling domestic car, the Olds Cutlass, at sensational new low prices during Ball Olds' number one sale. 2,000 San Diegans can't be wrong. You always get a better deal at Ball Olds Honda on the National City Mile of Cars.
Slip into something comfortable. The San Diego Hilton. Float on a private beach. Bike or jog around the bay. Play tennis. Unwind in the jacuzzi. Dine gourmet style in the Trade Winds restaurant. Relax at the cargo bar. Our gala ballroom is a city favorite for gala dinners, banquets, and meetings. The San Diego Hilton, where you can do it all or do nothing at all. It's your pleasure.
It is halftime at San Diego Stadium. Aztecs on top of Texas El Paso, 45-14. Boy, that's a lot of points. 59 points in the first half. That's enough for a whole ball game, usually.
Well, it sure is. It's very enjoyable. It's nice for a change.
Now, a couple of things in that first half. You went into the game without Jim Boudreaux, then John Jessup made a couple of catches early, and then he got hurt.
I think he got hurt in the second or third series, and that left us with no tight ends except the freshman walk-on tight end, Jim Lawton, who came in and did a super job for us.
Okay, but for a while there, you're going with three wide receivers, right? No tight end.
Right. We've done that on and off, and we always practice it in case of that eventuality, or sometimes we use that on third and long, and Matt kind of requested to get back to the other, and so we tried to give Jim the shot.
Now, what do you lose now when you take a tight end out and put a wide receiver? Does that hurt your running game?
Very definitely. And your inside passing game isn't quite as strong without that tight end, isn't it?
All right. Now, by the same token, in that first half, Donnie Roberts rushed for about 65 yards. So he continued what he'd done the week before in Las Vegas.
He's got a great feel for finding that daylight and making the most of it.
All right. Now, by the same token, Texas El Paso came back twice, got some scores. And it looked like they had a couple of good drives going there, and turnovers really hurt them.
Yes, it certainly did. And our defense did a good job of creating some of those fumbles. Our kickoff team also created a fumble that led to a touchdown.
What's the deal with Phil Smith? Are you trying to lead the nation in kickoff returns?
Well, I'll tell you, he's coming on. He made a great run last night with that pass reception.
All right, and then I guess your special teams were a little down on themselves for letting that one reverse of Texas El Paso go for
the yards. Yeah, we felt badly about that, right.
All right, so back to the drawing boards on special teams this week.
Yes, we'll correct that.
All right, Aztecs on top of Texas El Paso at halftime, back with more of the Doug Scoble Show right after this.
They're smoking hot. Smokey Gaines and his Aztecs are going to burn up the court with All-American candidate Michael Cage, plus high-scoring Zach Jones, averaging over 17 points a game. And here's a hot deal on Aztec basketball season tickets. A free pair of men or women's Nike all-court shoes from Second Sole with every $80 season ticket you buy. Get your Aztec tickets at any Second Sole store, Stadium Gate F, or call 283-7096.
San Diego State.
All right, coming up, second half of play at San Diego Stadium, the Aztecs and Texas El Paso. Now, Doug, when you're on top of a team by a large margin like that, what do you tell your team? I assume it's hard to keep the intensity level in the second half.
It is. It's something you have to be aware of and make your team aware of. We saw the film of Colorado State, and Colorado State got ahead 21-0 and lost the game, I think, 35-28. And every year, UTEP will beat one or two teams, and they'll come back and surprise them and take the momentum away from them. And it's tough to get momentum back sometimes.
All right, now are you, as a head coach, concerned in the second half about just playing the ball game, running that clock out, and getting out of there?
We just wanted to continue to play good, crisp football and not get sloppy.
All right, Aztecs on top of Texas El Paso. And second half coming up, we'll have the kickoff for the third quarter right after this.
At Second Soul, we got your number two for the price of one.
No matter what your game is, at Second Soul, you always come out a winner. Hundreds of athletic shoe styles, all the top name brands. And with every pair of shoes you buy at the regular price, Second Sole gives you a factory resole absolutely free. It's like getting two pairs for the price of one.
We got your number, Second Sole, two for the price of one.
Tommy Lee Jones stars in the engrossing story of the amazing Howard Hughes, Monday at 9.
Over and above golfing and motion pictures is flying, of course, Noah. Aviation, I'm going to be at some point in my life the greatest aviator in the world.
You do know she has a husband. If you want to marry Billy Dove, it's going to cost you over $300,000.
Take care of it.
Don't miss part one of the amazing Howard Hughes, starring Tommy Lee Jones, Monday at 9.
Here we go, third quarter action. And the Aztecs will kick off in this period, brought to you in part by Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you. And by Bolt Honda, a mile of cars in National City. 45-14. Aztecs lead it. So San Diego State, earlier this year, putting 52 points on the board against Iowa State in the home opener. 45 for 52 in most countries is 7. That's about a touchdown and a conversion. A kickoff at the 5-yard line. Charlie Davis, 15, 20, that's outside. Breaks a tackle and a block. There he goes again. 40, still running, and finally bumped out of bounds. They say he stepped out back at the 48. Just before going across midfield, but still a fine run back. 43 yards for Charlie Davis, and I think UTEP has found a new kickoff
return man. Here he comes again. Tonight's the first night he's returning kickoffs. He's got good acceleration. He gets through the hole. Breaks a tackle there. Just heads right up the sideline. And right about here, he's going to step out of bounds. Right there, right on the 45-yard line. 48-yard line.
All right, Miners have quite a hill to climb. Down 45-14, take over good field position at the 49-yard line. Jeff Riley, the quarterback, on first down. Pitch back to running back Gilbert Thompson. To the right side and cannot do so.
Good hit by Bill Fairbrother, inside linebacker.
Number 60, Doug Reed on the tackle.
Well, they spot the football at the 48.5-yard line. We'll call it no gain. Second down, 10, Rebel, Miners. Back to pass is Riley. Pressure delivered, has a man open. He takes it at the 40, bumps out of bounds. Wide receiver Eric Anderson in front of Darryl Hall. And close to first down yardage. Anderson will be back. He's a freshman. And they're going to measure. Is Riley cranking up his arm?
He lets it fly. He's got a good arm. Anderson coming back was just a quick deep out. Takes it looking for running room. Doesn't find any. Darryl Hall knocking him out of bounds.
First half, Riley was 8 for 14 for 122 yards. Matt Kopler, 20 of 27 for 275 yards. And receiving, Darius Durham got 7. So did Craig Ellis. Bernie, top receiver from UTEP, with 3. The first down, right? Inspection of Mike Vance. In the first half, Aztecs had 275 passing yards, UTEP 122. Miners rushed for 77 yards, Aztecs 79, including Donnie Roberts, 62 yards.
Good first half by Donnie, and that's only in 6 carries, so he's a little over 10 yards a carry.
Matt was intercepted once. Aztecs receded for 3-4 turnovers. Only negative in the first half was Jeslin, punting once, only 35 yards. Well below his average of 42-6. Handoff, first down, fullback Greg Adams, a freshman out of Odessa, Texas. He carries the football to the 36-yard line. That'll be a gain of 5 yards. Miners. Actually, Billy Alton, the head coach, said in the last couple of weeks he felt that their offense has come on a little bit. The big problem, he said, has been their defense has been woefully weak. He thought their special teams play was rather good. Club now is a 2nd and 5. They pitch to Thompson, trying to turn a corner. Runs in the pick. Doug Reed. Doug bumps him one, grabs him, then gets some help from some towels and pushes him backwards. Including Darryl Hall at cornerback.
And Mike Vance, number 93.
Darryl Hall, Mike Vance, 2 seniors playing their last games at San Diego Stadium.
Had a stun on Doug Reed coming to the outside, the linebacker taking inside. Nobody blocks him. There he is, standing right there. the little shoulder in. Here comes Mike Vance from the nose guard and a whole host of other tacklers.
Thompson's carried 10 times now for 55 yards. The Miners looking at a third and five. Riley under center. Option keeps it himself. Pitches it back to Thompson. And the Aztecs get through it nicely. Knocked him out of bounds after a gain of one, maybe 2 yards at the most. Cornerback Darrell Hall, senior from Long Beach, coming up there nicely. And short of first down yardage. 34-yard line.
It's a tough play to run in the sidelines. You run out of real estate there. You see the pulling guard, Belcher, 75. Riley here doesn't know where to take the ball. He makes a bad decision. Darrell Hall and Mike Fox coming up from his weak safety, also helping out on the tackle.
I've never understood why option teams will run the option to the short side of the field.
There's just no running room.
So they're going to try a field goal of 51 yards. Waddell, who has a 54-yarder this year. He's got this one on its way, but it's going to be short. He's way short. He came into the game, hit an 8 of 11. Of course, the air here in San Diego on a Saturday night is not exactly like 4,000 feet elevation in El Paso. Let's go back to the play. San Diego State on offense. Low snap again, has trouble, picks it up. Now has time, fires long, it's going to be intercepted, and it is at midfield by UTEP. A bad pass at the 40, Goins has it. Back down to the Aztec, 26, where Matt Cooper makes the tackle.
Well, there was no receiver around. Either somebody ran the wrong pattern, or Matt thought he called something that he didn't. And he threw it right into the hands of Goins, number 36.
That's the second interception of a Cooper pass tonight. So Brent Goins picks one off. And for him, his first of the year. UTEP now with the ball. Deep in Aztec territory. 10 minutes to play, third quarter. Miners at the 26 of San Diego State. Jeff Riley sets his club. Thompson and Moore and Adams are the setbacks. Option, Riley keeps it, puts his head down, tries to turn the corner. That's right into Doug Reed.
And Allendale,
the junior from Escondido. Two local products, Reed out of San Diego, Dale from Escondido. Look at Brent Goins, interceptor. It's an attaboy from his teammates.
Something different. They're not used to getting the ball turned over. Used to turning it over.
Previous play gained only 2 yards. Second down, 8. Riley will put it up. Blitz is on. Delivers on the flat and incomplete at the 13-yard line. Pass was intended for Kelvin May. Coverage.
Bernardino to coverage.
Picked it as Eric Anderson, 84. So they can be fast working up a second down and 8. Aztec fans, you want to keep track of Aztec action. Visit San Diego Federal's Del Cerro or 54th and Elko Home Branch and pick up your 81 Aztec Sports Calendar. And they're free. San Diego Federal, savings alone. Jones out in the slot wide left. Kenny Jones, and wide left is Jerry Jones on third down. Riley. Draw nowhere. Fullback Greg Adams. All he got was black shirts. Mike Vance.
Steve
Bob Levine, Steve Allman, all seniors.
We'll see it again. They had a blitzing linebacker. I believe it's Jerry Franey coming in. No, 26.
Bob Levine. Just flat out good penetration by Mike Vance. So a loss. The Miners now face with a fourth and 11. I believe they'll go for it.
They have no choice.
Yeah. 8:50 to play, third quarter. They trail 45-14. Field goal means nothing. So Riley will put it up. He's pressured. Rolls right. Grab. Throws. Intercepted. Darrell Hall at the 20. Still running. 30. And knocked out of bounds by Kelvin May. Oh, Darrell Hall picked off two last week. Nevada Las Vegas gets one here tonight at home.
It's his fifth for the season. And he could thank Mr. Riley for that. Riley was trying to get out of Doug Reed. Grip and just threw the ball away. It's good penetration by Reed. Good move. Breaks to the inside. Runs Riley out of the pocket. Now he holds him. Riley just throwing it away. Hall steps in front of the ball. Gets his fifth of the season. Breaks a tackle. Breaks two tackles. Moving to running back next year.
And so it's 45-14. San Diego State on top. We'll be back right after this.
This to the people who make the tough jobs all part of a day's work.
This bus for you. For all you do, the king of bees is coming through.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do.
This bud's for you.
It's official. Barlow's Honda is the number one Olds Honda dealer in San Diego with over 2,000 Oldsmobiles and Hondas sold in 1981. So, Ball is holding a special one-time-only number one sale during November on 1982 Honda Accords, Preludes, and Civics at all-new one-time-only discount prices. Prices that are substantially below Ball's regular low prices. 2,000 San Diegans can't be wrong. For the best deal on a new Honda, it's Ball Honda on the National City Mile of Cars.
Got it all.
Thinking about the Riviera, but just don't have the time? Why do you think the people of San Diego chose Mr. A's in San Diego Magazine's 1981 poll? As the number one restaurant in San Diego, could it be the atmosphere created by the combination of excellent service and continental cuisine with an aura of elegance? Or the wine list with over 300 varieties to choose from? Or perhaps the breathtaking view of the San Diego skyline? Go ahead, impress yourself. Why not? Mr. A's. Fortuna-owned restaurant where food and service are considered art.
With Bob Babich, this is Ron Rena. As San Diego State sets up shop at 28-yard line, and Coulter on first down will put it up. Dumps it out. Oh, boy, Craig Ellis had to watch the ball, but from behind, Darnell Grant came up and pounded it.
Good shot.
Short game.
2 yards. We'll see it again. It's just a quick out to Ellis coming out of the backfield. Grant wasn't fooled and puts a good shot. Surprised he held onto the ball.
In fact, it's no gain on the play. So second down, 10 coming up.
Second down.
Kobler's been intercepted twice. He's also thrown a couple of touchdown passes tonight. Matt will put it up again. Blitz is on, and he's going to be sacked as Matt hammered, waited. Finally, Herman Whiting got to him. As Miners just outnumbered the Aztecs. Herman, 6'2", a junior out of Houston. 87.
See him again. He'll be blitzing from the bottom of your screen, number 87. Comes right around. He was on a stunt. Beat Donnie Roberts here at the end. There's good coverage in the secondary because Matt, he's been getting the ball off pretty quick, and he had a hold up there, and that's one of the reasons Whiting got in there. That's the fifth sack on Matt tonight.
Well, in the shotgun, the Aztecs have a third and 18. UTEP has their safeties about 20 yards off the line of scrimmage. And three-man pattern has time. Now fires incomplete. That's a one bouncer to Phil Smith. Way short. Matt unhappy with himself. So that incomplete pass. Aztec offense sputtering here in the second half. Nance. Mike Jeslin comes on to punt for the second time in this half. Third time in the ballgame. San Diego State remains on top, 45-14.
Matt looks like he lost a little of the rhythm. He's not really throwing the ball like he did in the first half.
Yeah, I think piling up that big score in the first half, the intensity level has dropped a little. He is 23 of 33 for 298 yards. Jeslin, the punt. Turns the 10, gets it away. A boomer. Ooh, backs up, and lets it bound. 25, 20, across the 15. George Williams lets it roll and lets it down. At the 12 or 13 and a half for senior Mike Jeslin out of Redondo Beach. All right, 45-14 to score. We'll be back right after this.
Ready for some excellent service in an intimate Western atmosphere? It's El Cajon Bull and Bear, where the emphasis is on good food. Try our delicious salad bar, seafood or prime rib, or the house specialty, rack of lamb. There's a children's menu and nightly entertainment. The downtown San Diego Bull and Bear caters to the business person. Luncheon specials, happy hour from 4 to 7, lots of convenient parking, or plan your next party here, too. Now, if you're in the mood for some good food and entertainment, the Aspen Mine Company has it all on El Cajon Boulevard. All are fine Fortuna-owned restaurants.
Slip into something comfortable. The San Diego Hilton. Float on our private beach. Bike or jog around the bay. Play tennis. Unwind in the jacuzzi. Dine gourmet style in the Trade Winds restaurant. Relax at the cargo bar. Our gala ballroom is a city favorite for gala dinners, banquets, and meetings. The San Diego Hilton, where you can do it all or do nothing at all. It's your pleasure.
Aztec
Let's go back to the play. Texas El Paso on offense. Padilla will be kicking it away from about the 15. Double safety for San Diego State. Don Roberts, Gary Noble. And, oh, he slipped and fell, and it's a short kick. Rolling, though, nicely. And Nobles picks it up and fumbles that loose ball. Scramble. UTEP recovers. So Gary tried to be a hero and fool everybody, and in so doing, coughed it up.
Didn't work. What turned out to be a terrible kick ended up in UTEP's favor. I think Gary saw a little seam, and he wanted to pick the ball up on that first hop and go through before anybody could react. We'll see it right here again. There's the ball bouncing, and there's that seam. He just wanted to get right through it, but he didn't. Bounced it up and then kept them away from the ball, and the special teams of UTEP recover it.
Ball has been cut by the Aztec first.
Well, obviously a first down for the Miners at the 49 of San Diego State. Moore in a fullback now. Running back is Delbert Thompson. Wiley, the quarterback, he's going to pass on first down. Pressured by Rick Reeder. Gets away, fires as he's hit. A long pass that'll be incomplete and almost intercepted. Kenny Jones, the intended receiver, Robbie Chapman, and Darryl Hall. There, Darryl trying to go for another interception.
For number 91, Steve Allman was the man put the pressure on.
Incomplete pass, brings up a second attempt, and here it is.
Scrambling out, and we'll see Allman coming in right there with his helmet right in the sternum. Boy, feels pretty good, doesn't it?
Boy, he really cranked up a good. Darryl, Robbie Chapman,
fighting for the ball.
Jones.
Close.
Wiley is 0 for 4 passing. He's looking at his second and 10 now. He'll put it up again. Aztec blitzing again as he delivers. Incomplete. Center for Kenny Jones over the middle of the 38-yard line. Coverage by Mike Fox. Bring up a third and 10. Aztec basketball getting underway Friday night. Coming Friday, Aztec meet UC Santa Barbara Gaucho. The opener, 27-game schedule. Aztec was 15-12 last year. Fifth in the WAC. Hope to move up in the standings this year. Third and 10 here at this football game. As again, Whitey to pass, setting up the screen, does Thompson. And hit behind the backfield. And behind the line of scrimmage in the backfield and hauled down. Nice reaction by Rick Boyer and Todd Seaball.
Rick read that very well. He came in. He's the one that really changed the course of the play, enabling Seaball to make the tackle. We'll see it again. The Aztec front line's just teeing off. They know they have UTEP has to pass, and they're just taking off after the quarterback. There you see Boyer coming through. Gets a little foot up there for a little trip.
Kick is away. Fair catch called for by Donnie Roberts. He'll grab it at the 15. So San Diego State's offense has not scored in this period. They take over the ball, leading 45-14. We'll be back right after this.
This bud's for that first day on the job.
This bud's for you, for all you do. The king of beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do.
This bud's for you.
They're smoking hot. Smokey Gaines and his Aztecs are going to burn up the court with All-American candidate Michael Cage, plus high-scoring Zach Jones, averaging over 17 points a game. And here's a hot deal on Aztec basketball season tickets. A free pair of men or women's Nike all-court shoes from Second Soul with every $80 season ticket you buy. Get your Aztec tickets at any Second Soul store, Stadium Gate F, or call 283-7096.
San Diego State.
First down, San Diego State. Matt Kopler from the 15-yard line. Back to pass. Blitzes on, steps up, dumps it off. Durham at the 20. No, Smith, 25, and bumped out of bounds. Field goes to the 31-yard line there. Kevin Ward bumps him out. That'll be 15 yards and a first down as Craig Ellis says, nice going, Phil. 32 seconds to play.
See it from the ground view? Yes, the linebacker's blitzing. Matt just dumps it off to Smith, coming across the middle, nobody around. Just takes off, outruns one defender, knocked out of bounds.
Aztecs to the 31-yard line for the first and 10. Linebackers lining up about 5 yards off the line of scrimmage. Coker will put it up. pressured, hit, and gets away. In trouble, and will go down. The man got a second shot, and now a flag will go down, and I think it's going to cost UTEP. That was Walter Ballard, an outside linebacker out of Pascagoula, Mississippi.
Got so excited he got a sack, he started jumping up and top, up and down on Matt, and got a 15-yard penalty for a personal foul.
Essex may come out of this well instead of a 10-yard loss. 15 yards from the spot of the foul. They take the football out to the 38-yard line. 15 yards. They're using the hand. Now, that is not an automatic first down.
Good to see it again. Look at Ballard. And watch him. He's going to start. There he goes.
Oh,
just
boy.
Good shot on that back of his shoulders. That's uncalled for.
Yeah. Billy Alton, the coach, is out in the field.
Trying to figure out. Oh, he didn't mean to do it. He was just excited.
He's arguing, and so that cost UTEP a timeout.
In a play like that, the player should be ejected. There's no...
Well, if it was flagrant and you really did pound the guy in the back, I can't conceive that Ballard would be that stupid, knowing that a referee is standing right there.
That's right. But there's really no cause for that. The game's rough enough as it is, and you don't need that extracurricular activities.
So the Aztecs have now a second down and five. Kokler so far is 24 for 34 for 315 yards, four touchdowns. He's been intercepted twice. He's also scored a touchdown himself. Second and five. Matt Giz, Donnie Roberts. Not much hole there. Donnie runs into Dan Salter for what will be about a two-yard pickup. And that should do it. Short of first down yardage, Essex will have third and about two or three. But that'll do it for the third quarter of action as clock runs out. Three quarters completed here of this football game. Score is 45-14. San Diego State on top. We'll be back with fourth quarter action right after this.
Here they all come. The top trotting and pacing horses west of the Mississippi. Meet the new kids in the block. If you like them, there's still time to purchase your Turf Club membership or box seats. Harness racing at its best at Old Del Mar. Nine race card, Tuesday through Saturday, daily double, and five big exactas. Post time, 12:45. But don't tell Mama.
Let's go! Keep down!
They are an elite corps of fighting men, trained to take everything the enemy has and throw it right back at them. John Wayne stars in The Green Berets, tonight at 8.
There's still such a thing as due process.
Out here, due process is a bullet.
John Wayne and David Jansen star in The Green Berets, tonight at 8 on The Big Movie.
Third down and three, Aztecs. We open the fourth quarter of action from the 39-yard line. Matt will put it up on third down. Dumps it off, completes it. Lawton, the freshman tight end, goes to midfield and has a first down. And tackle made by Kevin Hoare. All right, Aztecs unveiling a new tight end tonight, and they get Boutreaux back next year. And they're recruiting a friend of Boutreaux from Santa Barbara City College, who's supposed to be a dandy.
He'll be very strong in the tight end department. Lawton shows that he could do something after he catches the ball. Broke the tackle and picked up some extra yardage.
First and 10, San Diego State at the 49-yard line. Might add to Boutreaux and Jessup hurt the first half, and that's why they're not playing. Coker will put it up on first down. Pressure now delivers Phil Smith on the run at the 45. The 40 gets a block. 30. He's at the 20, cuts in at the 10, the 5. Touchdown Aztecs.
This is what great speed will do for you. It's just a simple pattern. He runs away from one linebacker, breaks down the sideline. He has that 4-4 speed. Sets up a defender, cuts back in. He makes it look very easy when you have great speed and quickness.
Boy, you
makes up for a lot of things.
A good block by the freshman tight end Lawton, and also by Darius Durham, the springy. Makes it 51-14.
Fire
on to try to add a point. They're going to change football, though. Let's get a clean football in there. That one's dirty. as a 51-yard pass and run. Matt Kopler to Phil Smith. And for Mr. Smith, that's his second touchdown of the year. I've got the proper tools now for this football game. Jeslin to hold, Meyer to try the extra point. On its way. And it's true. 52-14. San Diego State leads University of Texas El Paso Miners. And Bob Babich and I will be back right after this.
Tommy Lee Jones stars in the engrossing story of the amazing Howard Hughes. Monday at 9.
Over and above golfing and motion pictures is flying, of course. No, aviation, I'm going to be at some point in my life the greatest aviator in the world.
You do know she has a husband. If you want to marry Billy Dove, it's going to cost you over $300,000.
Take care of it.
Don't miss part one of The Amazing Howard Hughes, starring Tommy Lee Jones, Monday at 9.
The 1980 Winter Olympics. Hockey team captain Mike Ruzioni helped clinch the gold for the U.S.
I'm Mike Ruzioni, the artist. Budweiser asked me to paint with these to help raise funds for America's Olympic athletes. Now you can own my painting and help our athletes train for 84. After all, there are a lot of Picassos. There's only one, Ruzioni.
Call 1-800-325-1488 for more information.
As we resume play, Texas El Paso on the attack. Second down, 3 after that 7-yard pickup. And back to pass as Wiley sets up and fires long and intercepted. Vernon Dean. That was too tall for Jerry Jones. Even he couldn't get that one, but Vernon did. And the senior cornerback picks it off.
That's his sixth of the year. He's having a fine season. Six interceptions. But again, he's going for the home run ball. Let's it fly. You see, Vernon has good coverage on it. Jones tries to cut in front of him, but it's just a little too tall for him. Vernon picks it off.
All right, so Matt does, in fact, come back to direct the team as they take over at the 14-yard line. Aztecs lead 52-14. Kopler sets his club on first down. Showing blitz, Matt will put it up. And they do blitz. He rolls out to the right, looks upfield. He's going to run it. And running for his life, Matt is pushed out of bounds at the 15-yard line. And doing so was Walter Ballard. And also Rusty Ogden, a safety. Gain of 2, maybe 3 yards for Matt.
Shot at the blitzing UTEP defense. Matt's being rushed out of the pocket there by Bubba Hoffman, number 61. Running, breaks a tackle of Bellard's, and steps out of bounds. Hoffman, who put the pressure on him, was an offensive tackle last season.
Second down, 7. Kopler will put it up. Blitz again. Stepped up, is trouble. Dumps it off, though. Completes it. Durham. He's at the 20. Has the first down. There he is, hauled down at the 29-yard line by Kevin Ward. And again, as Bob mentioned, that's just flat-out human speed, something you can't coach.
And something you can't stop if you don't have it yourself. Matt, under heavy pressure, dumps the ball off to Durham across the middle, and he just flat out runs it to the sideline, picks up the first down.
Well, Darius having a big night tonight. I think for the first down at their 29-yard line. Incidentally, you might add, if you missed the name Brad Williams tonight, Aztecs fine junior tackle, still injured, and is not playing this evening. First down. Kopler one more time to put it up. And again, a blitz, but he dumps it off in a screen. Craig Ellis. At the 30, still running. Falls forward, goes to the 37-yard line. Kevin Ward upends him. And in so doing, Ellis picks up 8 yards.
UTEP has a lot of people. Like Kevin Ward is listed as a wide receiver. He played some wide receiver. Now he's playing in the defensive secondary. Bubba Hoffman. We'll see this play again here with Matt. Letting lineman come through. Just dumps it off to Craig. A couple blockers out in front of him. You see 61 Hoffman making the tackle. And Bubba's no small man. He's 6'8". 260.
Second and 2. Kopler will put it up again. Has some time now. Flushed out of there. Running around and for his life. Looking for a receiver. Can't find any. Now it fires long. Down for a Sampson. And he takes it in. Then drops it. But out of bounds anyway. So it all becomes a moot point. Matt is just running for his life.
85, Don Kimball, linebacker, who plays tight end when they're in a, when they have a tight end situation. So they have a lot of people that are playing both ways for this UTEP team.
Yeah, I get the impression this coaching staff trying to sort things out personnel-wise.
Find out who could play where and what's your best position.
Fill some holes if they can find some athletes. Kerry Williams also has not played tonight. He's had a bit of a nagging injury, and so they're saving him for Japan. Aztecs very well could end the season 7-4 with a three-game winning streak. Good momentum going into 82. Third down and two. Kofler takes the handoff, dumps it off. Ellis passes the first down. Craig almost slips and gets hit, fights his way forward for some more yardage to the 43. There, Brian Kern levels him. And that's a first down, San Diego State.
On the tackle, number 49, Brian Kern.
San Diego State keeps the drive alive.
Good for 6 yards. And first down.
52-14 is our score. San Diego State on top of Texas El Paso. Durham sits out wide to the left. Clint Sampson in the slot to the left. On first down, Aztecs show some motion for the first time. Personal Sampson, and Kofler will put it up. Does. Clint over the middle, takes it in. Underneath the coverage, and he fumbles the ball. Loose ball, scramble. Also, there's a flag down. So, lots to sort out on this play. Apparently, the Aztecs recovered the fumble.
May have been a holding penalty in the backfield there.
Ooh, and there's an Aztec down hurt.
And there's the Texas El Paso Miner coming off hurt, number 87, Herm Whiting. See it again. The flag went down after the ball was already thrown. That's heading up, waiting for across the middle. Maybe a late hit. Sampson gets it. Nice trying to get away. Takes a good shot. Somebody put their helmet right on the ball.
And Long going
and
after
Long
it.
Gone for it, and
Darryl Yarbrough.
Yarbrough. I think Darryl came up with the ball.
Might have been a roughing the passer call.
It looks that way. I think Matt got hit after he released the ball.
Is the injured Matt? It might be Matt.
Matt Long.
Oh, fine center.
Well, that would now move Rich Moran over to center and bring in Rob Gilster at guard, I would presume.
There it is, the call. It is indeed. Roughing the passer, so a late hit on UTEP. Level against Matt Kofler. Aztecs get a first down out of it. So they cheated death there. Matt Long is a junior, 6'2", 250 from Ventura, has played very well at center this year. First and 10 Aztecs in UTEP territory at the 42-yard line. Matt, the pass, dumps it off. Ellis didn't see it coming. As the blitz was on, Kevin Ward, the closest man to it, and the ball falls incomplete. So the incomplete pass will bring up a second and 10 for San Diego State.
Again, Matt dumps it off. Ellis is supposed to be what they call a hot receiver. When a blitz comes on, one of the line running backs goes out in the flat, he's designated as the hot receiver. He's supposed to turn by looking for the balls, and Craig just didn't turn around that time.
Second and 10, San Diego State. Pass to pass one more time. Five-man rush, delivers, and incomplete at the 28-yard line. Coverage by Darnell Grant on Clint Sampson. And there's a flag down again.
There's Grant, number 31.
Holding.
Happy with his coverage.
Holding the call on San Diego State. The UTEP coaches, I guess, are not too uptight. I noticed that about 5 minutes before kickoff, two of them were in the press box cafeteria grabbing something to eat. So they didn't really have the uptights.
They weren't real worried about the ball game.
The intensity level was not high. They were concerned about their stomach. And there you see the indication, defensive coordinator. And you see there the indication, holding Aztecs. Moves the football back to the 40.
It's kind of hard going into the game when you have a 70% chance that you know you're going to lose it. I mean, there's nothing to be uptight about. You just don't have the horses or the material to go through the game and be competitive.
Second and 28. Aztecs have a little bunch. Matt, the pass, slant in. Durham takes it in and goes to the 49-yard line where he's hit down by Kevin Ward as they had Darius out there single covered. And in so doing, he picks up 9 yards, way short of first down yardage.
Quick slant. Matt just going back, takes a two-step drop and fires it. Durham catches it and Ward's right on it.
So, Aztecs now with a third and 19. We still have a lot of yards to go as Matt will crank it up one more time. Steps up under pressure, rolling out to the right. He's going to run it. And now he decides to pass as a man open. Durham at the 10, the 5, and just barely steps out at the 1-inch line. Oh, my. Now a flag's going to go down. I think it'll be
on the coach, I believe. He's one yelling. He's out in the middle of the field.
I think the UTEP coaches felt Matt was past the line of scrimmage when he threw. So on the replay, let's take a look.
See it. But Matt has a strong arm. He threw that. He was running. He didn't even have a chance to plan. He just let it go. Shows the strength of his arm.
Let's take a look at it.
See it again.
Well, we can't see the line of scrimmage from there. Matt pressure.
Good rush. Now he's running.
Now he's rolling out.
Here we go. Watch him throw the ball. He doesn't even sit up and plan. He just throws it on the run. He's not even, Peter, not even on the ground. There's the strength of his arm.
Darius all open.
Unsportsmanlike conduct called against Texas.
Great pass, great catch.
Well, ironically, Durham stepped out at the 1. 15-yard penalty against UTEP. Half the distance of the
goal line. Now it's on a half-yard line. So the penalty didn't hurt at that particular point.
No. Incidentally, the Aztec center is Bob Seiner, a walk-on. He's 6'2", 250, a junior from San Diego. For Matt Long, his first playing time at center, Kofler to Donnie Roberts. Touchdown, Aztec. That's nice for Donnie Roberts. Scoring another touchdown, which makes it now 58-14.
Their highest offensive output of the season. Well, meeting the 52 they scored at Iowa State.
There's an unhappy man, as you can see right there. Well, at least he's still in the ballgame.
Yeah.
Willie Alton, head coach.
Number 12, Dave Meyer, MC point after. Yeah. Holder, number 2, Mike.
So now a 58-14 score, and Meyer would try to add a point. Hold of Jeslin. Kick is on its way. And it's good enough. 59-14. San Diego State on top. Bob Babich and I will be back right after this.
This Bud's for the people who make the tough jobs all part of a day's work.
This Bud's for you. For all you do, the king of bees is coming.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do.
This Bud's for you.
It's official. Ball Olds Honda's number one in sales in San Diego with over 2,000 Hondas and Oldsmobiles sold in 1981. So, Ball is holding a special one-time only number one sale in all 1982 Hondas and Oldsmobiles. Now you can own America's number one selling domestic car, the Olds Cutlass, at sensational new low prices during Ball Olds' number one sale. 2,000 San Diegans can't be wrong. You always get a better deal at Ball Olds Honda on the National City mile of cars. Let's go back to the play. Texas El Paso on offense. So first and 10 at the 20. 59-14 score. Aztecs on top of UTEP. San Diego State next will play Air Force Academy in Tokyo. And we will not have the TV of that ball game here on XCTV6. This will be our final telecast. We will have later on, though, a seasonal wrap-up, a highlight show of the Aztecs coming up in December in the holidays. By first down, Jay Wiley, the quarterback. Texas club. And he rolls right on the option, has running room at the 20, 25, cuts back in, still running at the 30 to the 33-yard line.
Number 11, Jay Wiley.
It will be a 13-yard gain. Tackle made by San Diego State's Rick Reeder. Seniors for the Aztecs tonight. Quarterback Matt Kofler, tight end John Jessup, offensive guard Darrell Yarborough, four-year letterman out of Morris Line, San Diego. Three-year men, offensive tackle Brian Scuddy and Jerry Stabline, running back Craig Ellis. Fullback Steve Fogle, hurt a couple of weeks ago in a traffic accident. Fullback Eddie Ford. Defensive tackle Mike Vance, a good one. Nose guard Steve Allman, a three-year man. Linebacker Rick Boyer. Bob Levine, a four-year man. Linebacker Rick Reeder. As it's first and 10 for UTEP. And Wiley to pass. Pressure, hit, delivers, and way short. 5 yards short of the intended receiver, who is Charlie Davis. Also playing final game here at home for the Aztecs, senior cornerback Vernon Dean, who came over from USIU when they dropped football. Cornerback Larry Perry, Darrell Hall, strong safety Robbie Chabot, who played at Stanford for a couple of years and came here on his own. George Williams, and a fine punter, Mike Jeslin. Those seniors closing out their career here. The team itself has a road game remaining. Boy, what a road game to Japan. Second and 10, UTEP. Wiley option, cuts back in, and then is hit down by Corley. Done a nice job. Read that well. Coming off his nose position. Play gains but 2 yards, so it's third down and 8 for UTEP. The Miners running the football to keep the clock moving. Also makes it easier for them to catch their flight back to El Paso.
Definitely.
Third and 8 for the Miners. All right, here's Wiley to pass. Sets up, delivers, and completes it at midfield. Still running is Charlie Davis, an elusive little freshman from Florida. He goes down to the 45 of San Diego State. You know, it must be hard for them. They've not won more than one or two ball games for the last 6-8 years. Back when Dave Atkins was a sophomore, they were 6-5 or 7-4. That's the last winning year they had. But back about 15, 20 years ago, when Bobby Dobbs was a coach, they had some good clubs. They had players like Gary Keithley, who played for the St. Louis Cardinals, Fred Carr, great linebacker for years in the NFL.
They were called Texas Western then at that time, weren't they? Then they changed the name to Texas El Paso.
But the boy went downhill, and it just stayed there. First down now for the Miners in Aztec territory. So Wadi will put it up. Sets up, looks, delivers, has a man open, but can't hit him. At the 30, Kelvin May, the intended receiver. Another underclassman, a junior from Kansas City.
In a situation like that, it has to be hard recruiting what is known as blue-chip prospects, because what athlete that is an excellent football player would want to go to a school with a losing tradition when he could pick out from so many down in that Texas area, such as Texas or Texas A&M, and have a chance to go to a bowl game or even get some recognition more than he would get at UTEP.
But conversely, they can't come this way either and recruit the good kids out of California to go there.
Sure.
So they're kind of stuck geographically. But I think if I was them, I would really just recruit quarterbacks and wide receivers and put the ball in the air a lot. Oh, and the option, he started to hand off to the dive man, and the dive man slipped the bell, so he kept it himself, and May turns the corner, tripped up at the 44.
Good play by Wiley. Showed he had some good reaction. The dive man fell down. He almost lost the ball there.
Oh, Marco Geach, right there defensively. Marco from the San Pedro area. Walk-on senior, double transfer, went to Arizona, Arizona State originally, and now 3.5 minutes to go. The Miners have the ball with 3rd and 10. And Jay Wiley will put it up again. Pressured, hit, and hammered. Sack back to 46. And the Aztecs get to him. A couple of them there. Corley 76.
It's all made possible by 59, Rick Reeder. That game come up. One, there's Corley finishing them off. Couldn't see the number of the other.
It was Doug Reed, wasn't it? Or would Doug be out of there by now?
I think Doug has been out the last two series.
So, 4th down, Padilla to punt. Gary Nobles waits for it. And the kick is away. Floater. Nobles will wait for it. Bound. And lets it go wisely, rolling to the 2. And the UTEP men, unwisely.
When things go bad, they go bad.
Oh, yeah. And rolled in for a touchback. 59-14. San Diego State on top. Bob Babich and I will be back right after this.
Thinking about the Riviera, but just don't have the time? Why do you think the people of San Diego chose Mr. A's? San Diego Magazine's 1981 poll. As the number one restaurant in San Diego, could it be the atmosphere created by the combination of excellent service, continental cuisine, with an aura of elegance? Or the wine list, with over 300 varieties to choose from. Or perhaps the breathtaking view of the San Diego skyline. Go ahead, impress yourself. Why not? Mr. A's, a Fortuna-owned restaurant where food and service are considered art.
The Coke Machine. It serves ice-cold, refreshing Coca-Cola. Hardly ever runs out. We call this the Coke Machine, too. 12 cans of Coke in one easy-to-carry pack. And it usually costs less than 2 6-packs. It slips neatly into your refrigerator. 12 cans chilled together, but pop out one by one. And if you want a choice, meet the Tab Machine. It's right next to the Coke Machine. In your stores now.
So at the 45-yard line, Miners will set up their offense. 59-14 score, Aztecs lead it. Freshman Jay Wiley remains the signal caller. Wiley will cast off, blitz is on. Oh, he's setting up a screen. Bernie at midfield. Gets by a man, 40. He's running free at the 30. Goes down to the 20 and finally stopped at the 17-yard line. Kelly Bernie, the UTEP, so they've been going to that screen a lot tonight and finally got some big success out of it.
That time the Aztecs playing deep, they don't want to give up the 6 points. Let them throw anything short and medium. They hit him with the perfect play, the screen, everybody was back deep. Bernie gets a block right here, and he just takes off. Down the field, trips him up here for the Aztecs.
Can't tell, but with Willie McIntyre.
Willie McIntyre, okay.
At the 17-yard line, first and 10. UTEP, 1:18 to play in the contest. Wiley will throw it again. Big drop, trying to set up a screen. Pressured, hit, gets away, hit, and, oh, now he throws the ball. This is going down, but they don't throw a flag. Oh, and they won't.
Oh, should be a flag on top of that.
Boy, Jim O'Brien was the man putting pressure on him, number 90 for San Diego State. Well, let's take a look.
Pressure by Jim. That's his second sack. He was one in on the other one with Corley.
Second down and 21. Wiley fires long, so long it goes into the band. Intended for Kelvin May, who did not have a tuba or a trumpet, so it's an incomplete
pass. And the
first
trumpeter.
That's right. So the incomplete pass, unfortunately, stops the clock with 51 seconds to play. Third down and 21.
Third down.
Aztecs lead 59-14. And back again is Wiley to pass. That's up, hit, and sacked one more time. After the 41. So after the screen pass went all the way down to the 17-yard line, the Miners are now pushed back to the 40. That's the seventh sack by the Aztecs.
Bob Levine on a sack. All right. Here you see Bob.
Senior, cranked up, playing in front of his parents.
Had a fine game tonight. Made a lot of nice plays.
And for whatever reason, UTEP calls a timeout, stopping the clock with 28 seconds. They have a fourth and about 8 million to go.
Fourth and 33 is going to ask the coach, what should I do?
Aztecs gone well over 400 yards passing tonight.
Last 2 weeks, the offensive put
really
things together.
A job, yeah.
Start running the ball a little better. Matt started throwing the ball with the timing he had in the early part of the season. The offensive line doing a better job on picking up the blitzes and adjusting to different runs. So they started coming together toward the end of the year. I think it's going to be a pretty good year.
They're going to
have the momentum going in there.
Well, they scored. First time they got their hands on the ball, Colter to Durham. They scored again 2 minutes later after a fumble. It was Craig Ellis in a 4-yard run. They then came back again in the first quarter to score on a 14-yard pass to Donnie Roberts. It led 21-7. 24-7 after a field goal by Meyer. Second quarter. He scored 3 more touchdowns. So the Aztecs back on 14 in the fourth quarter. Lead 59-14. Fourth down, Wiley to pass one more time. Sets up, delivers long to the end zone. It will be intercepted. Intended for Kenny Jones. Intercepted in the end zone. Leo Ramos. All right. Boy, it is. Everybody have fun night.
Watch the shot Bob Levine puts on the quarterback Wiley right there, and he was lucky he didn't get called for a late hit.
So the Aztecs,
Ramos playing it well, getting an interception.
A lot of interceptions tonight, 3 or 4. So the offense will take over at the 20 with just 20 seconds to play. Run it out here at home at San Diego Stadium. The Aztecs are a little portent of the future.
By number 42, Leo Ramos.
Rick Hansen on the center. On first down. Rick to Eddie Ford. Hold up the middle. And there goes Eddie. 25, 30, still running. Finally hit down at the 37-yard line by Kevin Ward. And a 18-yard gain for senior Eddie Ford.
That's his first carry from the line of scrimmage this year.
Well, he had a draw on a previous series.
Right.
They lost yardage.
That goes right again.
That's what
he's good acceleration.
People, a lot of people thought that was going to happen this year.
Well, he's had a lot of leg problems. He's so tightly wound that he gets a lot of pulls.
But the clock running down.
There it is.
Well, the Aztecs win it, 59-14. This is our last telecast. Bob Babich, a pleasure working with you this first year. Enjoyed it very much. You did a good job.
A lot of fun, Ron.
All right, thank you. And also thanks to Bill Chestnut and Larry Hart. San Diego State by winning.
Teenage Witch terrorizes a suburban family in Stranger in Our House, starring Linda Blair. Linda Blair stars in Stranger in Our House, tonight at 6.
The endless vacation begins with a mercury.
Really sorry, Joe. Changing plans, decided to go.
The 14, San Diego State with a romp over Texas El Paso. And here at the Hilton Hotel at Mission Bay, I'm Ron Reno with the head coach, Doug Scovel. Doug, I guess one of the pleasing things is he played so many people, guys who've been out practicing, never got a chance to play in games like second and third stringers and walk-ons, and that gives everybody a chance.
It does. It gives them a good feeling, and they all deserve it so much. They've all worked hard on the scout team, and it's good to see them get out there and show their stuff and get ready for next year.
We saw tight end Tim Lawton, center Bob Seiner, running back Eddie Ford. The list goes on and on. Willie McIntyre, George Williams, and... That's Marco Geach is kind of neat for all those guys.
Leo Ramos, a freshman,
made
an interception in the end zone. And, they all got
that's kind of fun. Now, by the same token, the Aztecs, by winning, are 6-4. And from a program standpoint, your first year, now you're assured of a winning season. So that really has got to help your program.
Very definitely. We feel we're on the upswing and that we're going to go on and build on this season.
All right. Now, that, by the same token, means that you're going to be out after the Air Force game next week, out recruiting. I guess it's a lot easier to recruit when you got a winning record than when you're 2-10.
Oh, definitely. It helps, and they know that we're building and that they can be part of the program. And we've had a lot of young men come and watch us during the season, and they all seem to be impressed and interested in joining us.
Now, are you primarily looking for this next recruiting year, high school kids or JC?
Primarily high school. We're going to just take a minimum, probably 7 or 8 at the most, junior college, and about 22 or 23 freshmen.
All right, and that occurs right after the Air Force game. Now, Air Force in Tokyo, Japan, a short work week for you, because you got a heck of a long trip.
Boy.
they're a wishbone team, right?
Right. They're a good football team. They only trailed Notre Dame at the end of the third quarter, 14-7. They have a multiple tight defense, and they run the ball from the wishbone very effectively.
Now, I remember last year they were using like a 4-4 defense and just scrambling around trying to take the pass away. Is that similar to what they do this year?
Yes. They change their sets, and they give you a different look. They don't make many mistakes. They're a very smart football team.
All right. But it's a good one to win to end the season on.
Well, we're going to be going after it.
All right, Doug, good luck to you, because the Aztecs and Air Force Academy, we will not have that telecast here. This is our final one on XETV6. But coming up in just a couple of weeks, right around the Christmas holidays, we will have a complete seasonal wrap-up, Aztec highlights for 1981 of Doug Scovel's first year. So check your TV listings for that on Christmas here on Channel 6, Aztecs for 1981. And a final score, 59-14, Aztecs over UTEP. Thank you very much for watching. And that is our Aztec football show for today.